Greetings and welcome to Hindsight. We're at the depot in Duluth. We're going to go visit the train museum. So come and join us. Before we go to the trains, this is the historical St. Louis County Historical Society display at the depot. Thank you. We're inside the electric locomotive, going up to the cab area. Remember the locomotive I showed you at Two Harbors? Here's another one. Only this one looks like it's open. We can go up there and look at the cab. And they have it set up so it actually turns the drivers. I'll meet you in the cab. This is the engineer's side. Over here is the fireman's side. Take a look inside the firebox. A lot of knobs and gauges and stuff to take to pay attention to.
Sequence test of locomotive 227. Headlight on. Running board lights on. Cab ground lights on. Tender lights on. Marker lights on. Drive wheel set number one on. Drive wheel set number two on. Number 227 was one of 18 Yellowstone-type Mallet locomotives built by the Baldwin Locomotive Works for the Mesabi Road during World War II years 1941 and 1943. During her 20-year operating life, she hauled over 40 million long tons of iron ore from the mines of the Mesabi and Vermilion Ranges to the docks at Duluth and Two Harbors. She weighed in at 566 tons and stretched 128 feet in length, one of the largest and most powerful steam locomotives ever built. Capable of developing over 6,000 horsepower, she made routine work of handling 180 to 190 car trains weighing more than 18,000 tons. As a contrast, number 227 had a pulling power 30 times that of the William Crooks. When working at full power, she consumed 10 to 12 tons of coal per hour and evaporated water into steam at the astounding rate of 12,000 gallons per hour. The big engine was restored for the museum thanks to the efforts of the Duluth, Mesabi, and Iron Range Veterans Employees Association, which contributed over...
This is our railway post office car. The train would pick up and deliver bags, mail in these sacks. The men would sort it over there. Sort it for each town. And then throw it in a bag. And then when they reach that town, they put it on one of these. They throw it out when they get to the depot, and the next bag of mail would be caught by this thing. This is Fallen Flag Wall. Winona and St. Pierre became part of Chicago Northwestern. Well, that's it for the depot. Our next stop is Canal Park. Hopefully we'll catch a ship coming through the canal. Canal Park is gonna wait. We decided to ride the train. Thank you. Oh, we're on our way.